All right, yeah, I can't land.
So we're going to work on passing this position. So when we're getting that takedown, we got to shrink the angle, get into here, right? So we end up in this position a lot. A lot of times we start rolling off from the ground. The person just sits down in front of you like this, and this can be like frustrating to deal with, right? So what I want to do is I want to go hands either on his hands, his forearms, his biceps, or his shoulders. I'm going to get my head on his shoulder, right? Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pummel my hands inside and go around his waist. Lock up another body lock. So this time, first time we were using an S grip on the feet, this time we're gonna go palm. If you can do an S grip without fucking your hands up, then go ahead, but it really hurts your hands when that body weight's on. So usually the gable grip, wrist to wrist, is better.
So I come inside, and then once I get around his waist, I'm not gonna drive forward. What I wanna do is sort of pull him to me. Now see how I got like that? I have like my fist in the middle of his back. It's very uncomfortable for him. Right? And again, my elbows are clamped to his hips. I'm not pulling with my biceps, I'm just planting my elbows in. Whatever side you're looking to, that's the side you're gonna go to. Okay? So you guys come behind me so you can see what my feet do. Sometimes the guy's knee is up high and tight to your body, so see how it's like tough for me to get over. All you gotta do is just kind of walk on your knees a little bit to the side, and he comes down enough, and then you can bring your knee over. I bring my knee over his knee, and into his hip, and I transfer my head to the other side, and I just kick this leg back, and scrape my knee under. So we start here, hand fight, head on the shoulder, pummel inside, pull the hips in, and clamp your elbows down tight, okay? Now I'll go to the other side. So I'm gonna take my left leg at this, okay? Yeah.
So I'm gonna release the body lock just so it's a little bit more comfortable for him.
Shoot my leg back, and I gotta get in front of the same side foot, okay? From here, step your knee over. When your knee steps over, don't put it on the floor. Bring it right into his hip.
And move your head to the other side. Try to do every movement like this as tight as possible. One leg kick, big. Okay, once you're down, I'm just gonna straighten my knee in front of his knee and use my leg to push his leg out of the way.
Once you get your knee down and in,
bring your head to the other side. Try to maintain the body lock the entire time. Just keep your elbows kind of the entire time.
You guys got it?
We just start on the ground now.
So we do the same thing. So once you get your knee under here, what I want you guys to focus on is turning the guy's hips away from you. So his escape usually is to turn his hips this way, slide his hips back in. So if you can make the guy's hips go that way, like very, very hard for me to ever get back into his guard. Okay. So, maintain the body lock as long as possible. I start walking myself back in towards his legs. And now, once I get to this position, what I'm going to do is I'm going to step my right leg up under his knee. And now I can really use my legs to drive his legs over to the other side.
Okay. And you can do this, not just when you have a body lock, you can do this anytime you're in side mount. Especially no-gi, it can be tough to get control of the guy's head because there's no gi to grab on, okay? If you can't control the guy's head, that means you probably can control his hips.
So, just walk back, walk your knees under his butt, and I step my leg up. I try to drive my knee in between his leg.
Myself, I still like kickstand. Right? From here, where this hand's gonna come under, I'm gonna grab his strap and I wanna kind of get the turn. So once he's in this position, you realize, especially if my weight on his hips, you can't turn this way. Okay, so you can't start to turn that way. Now from here, once he sort of breaks that plane, take the hand that's by his hip to up under the neck. Wrap around, with the hands, and then bring my head down and my shoulder forward. Okay? It's very important that as you go, so once my elbow's on the floor, it never comes off the floor. But I don't do this. here, you don't even maintain this leg drag position. You move it out a little bit towards his head. Nice. Okay, don't use your arms to do it. Use the pressure from your body to kind of move forward.
So let's just start in the side mount like this. I walk my hips in, flip my leg up, drive them through. Your personal mount's going to turn a little bit. Keep your arm in. So I just put my hand here and I'm going to walk my hand and tighten around the mat. Okay. Then from here, I want to keep my ear on the shoulder, bring my head to the mat.
Put my knee, everybody come over here so you see how I put my knee under his hip like this. It makes it hard for me to turn back to the floor. See the direction that I'm choking? I'm not laying on the floor and squeezing with my arms. I'm sort of driving my weight into his neck. Okay, so I wasn't using my arms at all. I just pulled myself forward. Walk the hips. Try to get your knee under that leg. Once the knee's under, slide your hip through. He's going to turn. Put the hand under, you can walk it in tighter, loop around the neck. Always try to make it a little bit tighter. You can never be too tight with the neck and hands. Start with your ear on the shoulder, bring head down, take my knee under his hip, and then again, watch the rotation of my body. I'm bringing myself to around the corner. There you got it. 1, 2, 3. Sometimes you'll get to this position and for whatever reason it's not working. Again, maybe the guy's got really good defense, the guy's too skinny for it to work. For whatever reason, you're in this position and like you've been here for like 15, 20 seconds and nothing happened. Don't just bail on it. You still have a really strong control position. So what I'm gonna do, if I was like flat and squeezing real hard, I'm just gonna come up to my knees. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sort of like pull my right elbow towards me. I'm gonna drive my chest into him to try to turn him on his side. And every time you move somebody a little bit, you wanna get something under him so they can't go back. So I brought my knee under him, and I bring my chest under him. And then I slip my hand to the front. Okay. And from here, I'm just gonna drag the arm. More grip, so I have basically the seatbelt grip, and I always like to grab it for him. But once you get this, you have lots of options. I can step over and take his back. Over, step over, do more, and go in arm bars. You have a lot of options once you're here. So, if you're in the arm triangle for a while and it's not working, come up to your knees and then start driving the person up onto their side. See, I'm using my weight to sort of bring him up, and I slide my knee under his body. You kind of like jack him up, pull that in, and decide what you want to do. If you want to go for arm bar and more, or back it. This isn't working. Walk your knees and don't pull away and try to lift them up. Stay as glued to the person as you can. You start sort of driving them up on their side. Start driving them in, lift the body there. Lock up your grip and then choose what you want to do. I usually like to take people's backs, so I would step my leg in, sit to my butt, and take it back. You can go for the arm bar. I'm just going to loop my elbow around the head, swing the leg over the head, sit back with my knee up, and go for the arm bar. You can trap the Kimura, step your leg over, pin his arm down, finish the Kimura. Okay, so pick one of those or do all three if you like. But do the same thing. Go for the arm triangle, finish it, and then release the squeeze, come up and transition into something else. All right? 1, 2, 3.